Time now for our regular Thursday morning entertainment report with Angela Bishop. And, you know, I still claim after all these years that I would not have finished school if it hadn't been for Cat Stevens, that music playing in the background. So good to have him back.
It is good, and the concerts have been going incredibly from all reports. And last night, the artist formerly known as Cat Stevens, now Yusuf Islam, performed in Melbourne after a failed push to refuse him entry to Australia on the grounds he holds extremist political views. A Victorian MP wanted the controversial singer barred from our shores, saying he'd backed calls for Satanic Verses author Salman Rushdie to be killed. But last night, the Islamic convert performed his most memorable hits to an appreciative crowd.
The music take me where my heart wants to go.
Now known as Yusuf Islam, he will tour Sydney and Brisbane later this month. Nicole Kidman has been snapped taking daughter Sunday Rose to visit her grandparents in Sydney. The gorgeous Sunday, who's only been walking for a little while, was seen grasping her mother's hand and toddling next to her as they entered the home. The actress landed in Australia 2 days ago to celebrate Sister Antonia's post-wedding party on Friday night. But Nicole will be back to work soon, starring opposite Nicolas Cage in Trespass, an action-adventure directed by Joel Schumacher. Meanwhile, Hugh Jackman is set to slug it out in the boxing ring in his latest film, the futuristic Real Steel. The 41-year-old plays a former boxer who becomes a promoter for the now high-tech sport of robot boxing. The action sci-fi is being produced by Steven Spielberg and will open in theatres next year. The Harry Potter movies may soon be coming to an end, but the show must go on for its young stars. Rupert Grint, aka Ron Weasley, has admitted he needs to leave the Harry Potter bubble to work on other films, such as Wild Target, alongside Pirates of the Caribbean star Bill Nighy.
It's been a long time. We started this one last February, and it's been fun. It's going to be a great way to end, I think, the series. So. Yeah, I'm looking forward to it, but I think I'm kind of ready to kind of move on now.
Potter fans haven't got too long to wait for the seventh instalment. Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows opens in November. Former Baywatch hunk David Hasselhoff has made a return to the small screen, reprising his role in the soapy that made him famous, The Young and the Restless. That's right, everyone, Snapper is back.
They have no choice.
34 years ago, I walked through the doors of CBS and I could slip right back into this. A while back, maybe 10 years ago, I wanted to come back and pay homage to Bill Bell, because he's the one who gave me my start. And he gave me my first shot, and he believed in me. He knew that I was raw, but he saw something in me. I learned a lot from him. I learned a lot from his classness, from his tenacity, from his eye of talent. And to this day, people stop me and say, you know, when's Snapper coming back? And when we announced that I was coming back, the news was unbelievable. It was, people were stopping me everywhere after 34 years. Snapper's coming back to help his mother. She's not doing well, she's ill. Brings together Jill and Catherine and his sister Jill and Wings Hauser, my brother, Greg. And we are there for a vigil to try to save Mom's life. And I enjoyed just walking through the doors and feeling the energy of so many good times here.
One for fans there. Angelina Jolie is doing her bit for World Refugee Day. The actress and UN Goodwill Ambassador has released a video urging people around the world to remember the plight of refugees.
World Refugee Day. Please remember the millions of people around the world forced from their homes, whose only hope of return is to not be forgotten.
Jolie has travelled to more than 20 countries in her UN role since 2001. Legendary artist Prince is set to be honoured with a Lifetime Achievement Award at the end of the month. The 52-year-old will join the likes of James Brown, Whitney Houston and Diana Ross when he's presented with the tribute at the Black Entertainment Television Awards in Los Angeles. Not only has Prince won 7 Grammy Awards over the years and been inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, he's also snagged an Oscar for the soundtrack to the movie Purple Rain. He's the former addict turned international movie star, now engaged to the daughter of a preacher. That's the short life history of Russell Brand, the star of the new comedy opening today, Get Him to the Greek.
As a brand, Russell Brand is a screaming success, a stand-up comic who successfully transferred his larger-than-life personality to the big screen in his first lead role in Get Him to the Greek.
We really should get going if we're going to catch that flight.
Just change it to a later one.
Change it to the next one. Change it to the next one!
Have you ever drunk absinthe like from the 1900s?
No.
Russell reprises the role of rock star Aldous Snow that he first played in Forgetting Sarah Marshall alongside Jonah Hill. But Jonah has a new role as a record company dude who has to get a drug-addled Aldous to a concert on time.
The director, Nick Stoller, who directed Forgetting Sarah Marshall, I think he noticed a unique chemistry between Russell and I and wanted to explore that in its own film with us two as the leads.
Russell's role is a little like what he used to be before rehab for alcohol, drug and sex addictions. But playing such a role now is more like hard work than actually living it.
No, because you have to work really, really hard, you have to do long hours and you have to be very professional, you mustn't do anything bad or be rude to anyone and you've got to concentrate.
And all that professionalism has paid off. In a shock move for many of his fans, Russell's doing Shakespeare with Helen Mirren.
In it is Jimon Unsu out of Blood Diamond, Alfred Molina, wonderful actor, Alan Cumming, him out of American Beauty, Chris Cooper, that's all weird and sort of a weird gay dad, all sorts of right, proper, brilliant actors. Now, I was in there, like, and I'm used to just mucking around for a job, and then I had to do Shakespeare.
Yeah.
Shakespeare.
Yeah.
Like school. So I done it, and the lady, Julie Taymor, says I'm good at it. It was nice.
We'll see that later in the year. Meantime, Russell is hopeful his singing in Get Him to the Greek might see him climbing the rock charts for real.
I'd like Furry Walls to be number one.
That would be grand.
In Australia, but and then is there a show and I could come on it and they'd say, Russell's your number one, well done.
Sure there is. We used to have Countdown. It's not quite the same anymore, but it...
Why did you get rid of Countdown?
Well, Molly got busy doing other things.
Molly
Meldrum.
Molly, you selfish, selfish woman. Come on.
Molly is a bloke.
Molly, you selfish man cow.
Now, of course, no Russell Brand interview is complete without a bit of innuendo. Reading about all the...
One leg there.
Oh, it's a new thing. Well, it is a new thing.
Now you're in a sex V.
Am I?
Bryce!
Keep yourself nice. You're marrying the daughter of a preacher.
Keep yourself nice. That's really good advice. Thanks, mate. I am marrying a preacher's daughter.
Did you ever think? Did you ever imagine? Did you ever dream?
Well, I do dream and imagine some pretty peculiar things, and so it probably came up in one of them. Probably in an erotic fantasy around the back of a church or something. But now that it's actually happened, it's pretty crazy, isn't it?
It is pretty crazy.
Because imagine that. I go, oh, all right, love, so what do your parents do? Oh, they're preachers. All right, I'll see you later.
Yeah.
Because I thought, how's this going to work?
The wife-to-be is, of course, American singer Katy Perry, who has turned Russell into the opposite of the playboy he plays in Get Him to the Greek.
Excess. Bacchanalia fueled by self-destruction. The self-destruction is an appealing trait because it's the acknowledgement of the inevitability of death. It's like taking control of your destiny. We are all going to die, every single one of us. No one is going to be excluded. Every human that's ever lived that ain't alive now is dead. And we're all going to die. So if you sort of think, well, F you, forces of the universe, I'll destroy myself. There's something madly brave about that.
Yet you've turned your life around.
Right round, like a record, baby.
I think if we can finish on a quote by Pete Burns, all is good with the world. Thank you so much.
It was always heading to Pete Burns.
It was.
I got your hand.
Nice to meet you.
You too.
Thank you so much.
Just another day at the office, Ronnie.
You were between Russell Brand's heels.
Heels, yes. Yes.
Interesting.
You keep yourself nice too.
Yes,
hey, well. Other breaking news. Ashton Kutcher's coming to town next month. Very exciting with his new movie, The Killers.
You'll be even more excited about that.
Oh, my word.
I know you will be. Thanks, Angie. That's great.